Hi guys, today I'm going to show you how to export your processing still frames and animations in order to upload them to Instagram or use them as source material in other graphic software such as Premiere Pro or After Effects. I'm going to assume that you have already got processing installed. You're also going to need a terminal emulator. I'm on Windows and I'm using Commander, which is a console emulator. You can either use Commander if you're on Windows or the native terminal app if you're on a Linux or a Mac. Since you're going to be exporting a file, the size of your canvas is very important. Here we have set it up as 700 by 700 pixels. In case of Instagram, the optimal sizes are these. You can go for a square frame, 1x1, and 1080p by 1080p. Portrait size frame, 4x5, 1080p by 1350p, or a landscape frame size, 191 by 1, 1080p by 608p. I've already made a simple sketch, which is this black and white drawing. In order to export a single frame, we use the save function, which takes as a parameter a string with the name of the file that we want to save. The file is going to be saved in the same directory that your project is saved, so make sure to save your project first in order to relocate your exported frame. Here I'm going to use exported_frame.png. And if we now uncomment this line and run the sketch again, we should get a 700 by 700 image file named exportedframe.png in our project folder. Which is this one over here. Now it's time to see how we export a sequence of frames that will comprise our animation. We have made a simple animation sketch, which we can see here. If we uncomment this line, it will only rotate for 180 degrees, and then the draw function will stop looping. Let's run the project again. In order to save the sequence of frames, we use a saveFrame function, which takes as an argument the name of the file we want to save, but also includes an index to name the different frames. Here, every file is going to be saved in a folder within our saved project folder, so once again make sure that our project is saved first. Inside the folder, each PNG file is going to start with BW-, followed by three digits that indicate its frame. The three hash symbols here indicate that we want three digits. We could use any number, such as 4 or 5, depending on the number of frames we want to save. In this case, we use 3 digits, so we would be able to save up to 999 frames. If we now uncomment this line and run the project, we should get our sequence of PNG images. And now to see that we actually have the PNG files. And they're all here, all 180. While exporting the frames is not that hard, making them into a video is a bit tricky. Processing comes with its own Movie Maker tool, found under Tools, Movie Maker. We need to provide the folder with our frames. This is this one over here. And pick a file name for our output file. I'm going to go with a name I just thought of, this movie. We're gonna save this. And we should now have our movie. Now there are some issues with this. As we can see, Windows cannot play the file with its native software. I'm gonna open it with VLC. And we can see that the playback is quite choppy. So what I like to do is use another software called ffmpeg, which can be found here. ffmpeg is a very popular console-only software for handling video and audio. Now the people that make the software only provide source code as stated, but you can get a pre-compiled build depending on your operating system. I'm on Windows. I got the build from this link. After you download the zip file of the build, unzip it and place it somewhere on your drive. In order to be able to run the software from every folder, using your console emulator, I would advise you to add ffmpeg to your path. In Windows, in order to do that, you click the Start button, start typing environment, click on Edit the System Environment Variables, click on Environment Variables, find your path under the System Variables, click on Edit. Here you would browse, find the directory that you placed ffmpeg in and click OK. I've already done that, so I'm gonna cancel. You should see it here. Keep clicking OK until you get rid of all the windows you have open. And run your terminal with the software of your choice. You need to cd into the folder that you saved your frames in, and then type this ffmpeg command that I'm going to explain. This iFlag is an input. Tells the program that we're gonna use these files over here. This means that all your files start with bwdas, and then you have three digits, .png. You're using libx264 as a video codec, and your pixel format is YUV420p. This last part is the output file name. If you run this, you're gonna get a movie file. We can see here. As you can see, Windows can open the file as well. It still runs better with VLC. I just found these flags that I mentioned to give me the most compatibility in order for Windows to open the file or upload it to Instagram. Now you can go on and share your creation with the world. If you want to upload an image to Instagram, you can actually do it on your computer. In order to be able to upload an image, you need to actually enable the developer tools. Go to a mobile view, reload the page. As you can see, I'm already logged in. I can click on this plus button, find the image that you want to upload, find it here. Then you can click on next and actually upload the image. If you want to upload a video, unfortunately, you need to still use your phone. So you need to transfer the video that we created to your phone and then upload it through that. And that's it for processing and exporting images and videos and optionally uploading them to Instagram. I'll see you in the next video.